Last year I made a video full of topics that you might need to know for your MMIs for 2021. Going into 2022, I know the topics might have changed a little bit, so this year I thought I'd make an updated version for 2022. These are going to be a bunch of different topics that might come up in your interviews, a bit of information about all of them, and a few examples of some questions that they might ask you guys. The first topic that's been talked about quite a bit recently is diversity. There's new data that shows that the NHS workforce is more diverse than it's ever been before, with a rise in BAME doctors, but despite the fact that there's been a rise in diversity, ethnic minority staff and BAME staff currently remain underrepresented in senior positions, including consultant jobs and academic positions. There's also data to show that BAME students are less likely to get a place at medical school than white students. There's data showing that medical schools and royal colleges need to take more action to try and improve the diversity in their institutions. An example of a question that they might ask you is, why do you think diversity is important in medicine? Drink spiking incidents have become a lot more common recently, especially with incidents where people have been injected with drugs. After a number of events, NHS Grampian or Grampian, which is an NHS trust in Scotland, which released a statement with some advice on what you can do to help people stay safe on a night out. Because most people that have been spiked will probably end up going to A&E or to hospital after they've been spiked. It's possible that this might come up in your interviews because it does relate to medicine. The key things for you guys to know is that it's being called an epidemic at the moment, and it's mainly happening in the hotspots across the UK. It mostly affects women, but it can affect men too. And it's been getting a lot of legal attention, with a lot of petitions calling for the government to make it a legal requirement to search people before they come into a club or a bar. An example of a question that they might ask you in your MMI is, what do you think the NHS can do to support people who have been spiked? Vaccination/COVID is a possible topic that they might ask you guys about. Because it's been so prevalent in the news, I don't actually think it will come up because there's literally an unlimited amount of things they could ask you guys about. Recently on the news, there's been a lot of conversation about whether or not we should make everyone have the COVID-19 vaccination. Obviously, there's ethical pros and cons to this, but here's a little snippet of an interview of a woman who decided not to have her COVID-19 vaccination.
Louise, the obvious question, of course, is what are your reasons for not being vaccinated?
I don't trust it yet. I think I'd rather wait until we've got long-term data and evidence coming back in. You know, I know it's gone through so many rigorous, you know, tests and such, but it is still classed as being in trials until 2023. And, you know, I know it was rushed through for emergency purposes, but I just don't feel that we know enough about it yet.
Because of the latest controversy on vaccinations, I think they might ask you guys something along the lines of, do you think we should force everyone to have the COVID-19 vaccination?
Just a quick disclaimer, guys, despite the title, these aren't the only topics that might come up in your interviews. Med schools sometimes put on their websites the things that they might interview you on. So for example, at Newcastle, it says on their website that you could be interviewed on integrity, communication, empathy. So it's worth having a look at like some other topics and some other like personal skills you've got and qualities that you've got, because if you reflect on that, you'll probably be more prepared for your interview. This video is just based on a list that the Medic Portal put out a few weeks ago on a few topics that might come up in 2022 MMIs. There's also a bunch of ethical dilemmas that I didn't touch on, for example, Charlie Gard. That's a topic from a few years ago, but Ali Abdallah's made a really good video. It's from 3 years ago, but it's still like really valuable, I think. There's also that whole thing about NHS staff are only getting a 1% pay rise, even after the pandemic and everything. So that might come up in your interviews. There's so many topics that I could talk about. I just wanted to keep the video short. Let me know if you'd like another video similar to this. And yeah, I can definitely make that for you guys.
The topic of AI in medicine came up in my interview back in 2019. And I remember being really, really confused when this came up in my station. I remember they made me watch a video about it, and then I had to like answer a question, and I was just so confused. What you need to know for AI in medicine is that it's currently being used to diagnose cancer. It's being used in radiotherapy. It's being used for also virtual nursing, and it might be used in the future for surgery as well.
This is how a radiologist diagnoses pneumonia.
84-year-old female, shortness of breath, period. Frontal and lateral views of the chest, period.
This is an algorithm called ChexNet that's trained to do the exact same task. And this is how it performed against 6 doctors analyzing 50 chest x-rays for pneumonia in a recent test at Stanford.
There are some pros and cons to AI in medicine. Some of the positive aspects are the fact that it could be used to help support the delivery of the NHS's five-year forward view, which is just a plan for the government on what change they want to make in the NHS and what that should look like. AI in medicine can also be used to help address the health and well-being inequalities and to help predict which individuals are at risk of illness. So this means that the NHS can target their treatment more towards them. However, one of the downsides is the fact that public data would be widely used by a lot of robots, essentially. So a lot of people are worried about the fact that artificial intelligence will have access to their name, age, address, and a lot of their personal information. I think if they were going to ask you guys about AI in medicine, they might ask you a lot about the ethics. So they might ask you something like, do you think the NHS implementing AI would be beneficial to patient safety? In 2018, Ireland had an abortion referendum.
In 3 days' time, Ireland will be voting on whether to repeal the Eighth Amendment in the country's constitution, a law that criminalises abortion.
The referendum meant that the law was changed in Ireland surrounding abortions. Previously, women would have to travel to the UK or order dangerous pills online in order to carry out their own abortion. Abortion was only allowed if the mother was at risk, and both the patient and the medical professional carrying out the abortion could be at risk of 14 years in prison. Most European countries and the UK would allow abortion up to 12 weeks, and the UK extended this to 24 weeks upon request. The impact of the referendum meant that many women no longer need to travel abroad and endanger their lives in order to get their abortion. They could potentially ask you, how would you demonstrate empathy to a woman who's about to go through with an abortion? Euthanasia is the topic that comes up every single year because it has so much to do with ethics. Euthanasia is essentially terminating a sick person's life in order to relieve them from illness. Something that they could ask you, again relating to ethics, is it ever right to end someone's life under any circumstances? Brexit is a topic that we've kind of not been speaking much about, especially in terms of medicine, because of like how much COVID has affected things, but this could potentially come up in your MMIs. They could ask you about how Brexit has affected the NHS in a good way or in a bad way, and they probably want you to give a balanced answer as well, so touch on the good and the bad. There's been a staffing crisis with 5,000 nurses having left the UK because of Brexit, who are originally from EU countries. The UK also had an issue with stockpiling medicines a few years ago, but these medicines were used up during the COVID-19 pandemic. Overall, I'm just wishing you guys the very best of luck. Let me know in the comments if you'd like another mock MMI. I know you guys really, really enjoyed those. They're the best. I think those are the videos on my channel that have the most views. So if you want another one for 2022, let me know in the comments. And yeah, best of luck for your interviews. Bye.